we're interested right now in how early life seizures can lead to later life cognitive deficits. We are trying to build upon an already established early life seizure model in zebrafish to see if these seizures then lead to autistic-like features, memory and learning deficits, and potentially full-blown epilepsy as they do in humans. Epilepsy is one of the most common neurological disorders in the country. I think it's fourth. For me, this kind of really pulled on both something that was very important, the fact that there is no way to take care of the pediatric epilepsy and to stop it, and also the part of the brain that I'm really most interested in is the development of these connections. The current epilepsy medications may or may not work in children. They're not great. Even if they do work, the brain is constantly changing, right? So they kind of grow out of the treatment. And plus, those treatments for any age are only treating the seizures. There's nothing that can block the development of a lot of these cognitive and social behavioral type of changes that often occur that become deficits to these children when they get older. How are the seizures changing the brain to lead to all of these things? It's really unclear. There are a lot of hypotheses out there and there's data building and building, but until we know, we can't find the treatment. Figuring out what's going on and then fixing it ultimately is the goal.